Hello, I am Maud and welcome on Women Run the World podcast. The show where you can listen to unique interviews of female runners that I met during my run trip world from 2015 to 2017. You will listen to interviews with no filter to understand why women are running, how it's different to run in Cambodia, Kenya or Brazil. Let's go and meet all these women who run the world. Welcome on episode number 29 of Women Run the World podcast with Lina's interview. Lina was Norhayati's daughter and she was really into sports and running. I could understand the differences between these two generations. 20 years of difference and a way of running totally different. One started late and the other really young. Let's listen to Lina's story. Hello.
Hi, hello.
Could you tell me who you are and what is your athletic history?
My name is Lina. Okay, about athletic, I think I started running when I was in primary school. And since primary, secondary, actually, I've been holding the number one for any events related to 100 meters, but not long distance actually, just sprint running. And after school, I went to university and I started to jog. Jogging because just follow my friends. And then when working right now, I think I prefer to get involved in trail running compared to normal marathon. Because my first trail run was just at the back of my office. There's a hill and we have a trail run event there, and that was my first time. It's really fun and I find that I'm better in trail run compared to marathon. I don't know, because during marathon my stamina, it can get really, it's like suffering a bit, just looking at the same view with the same momentum. Because if you're in trail run, you can control your speed depend on your strength. If there's a hilly, I will just walk actually. I don't really run. And I love it when we're going downhill, because that is the best part where I can catch most of the people that catches me, that run ahead of me. When we are going uphill, so going downhill, I look that in trail run. Actually, I do other sports also besides running. I think I'm good at running compared to doing anything with my hands, playing rackets or playing badminton or tennis or squash. I'm not really hand oriented, maybe.
More leg oriented.
Yeah, more leg. And yeah, I play indoor soccer also. And I really love outdoors. I love hiking. Last time I went to Kinabalu, my first mountain maybe, with my dad. And we go up and down on the same day. So it's really fun. And maybe I was still younger that time, so it really didn't really stress me much. And Rinjani, the second mountain, that was also very challenging. And I'm looking forward for maybe Kathmandu next time. Just one of my in my bucket list. And I'm also looking forward to join like Ultra Trail. I know the distance will be very long, but I never involved in that long distance trail run. I think the longest just like 6 kilometers. yeah, the recent one, the trail run that was in Putrajaya. Actually, I tried my best to get top 10 because they get prize for that, but I managed to end up 11. So it's just I missed one. I should just take over the first lady in front of me.
Could you tell me
Why did you begin to run?
Maybe during that time, it started all in school. I think it influenced me a lot until now, because I think in school I'm considered a quite short person. So most of them, like playing netball, they will choose the higher students. So I end up in running, and I realized that I run faster than my other friends, and they don't want to get messy, dirty running, because running is, during that time we run barefoot, so they don't want to get their feet dirty. So I don't mind about that, and that's when I get involved in running. And I don't know, I realize there's like a calmness when you're running, especially when you're listening to music while running. Surely you can get absorbed in the environment, looking at the sceneries. I prefer running in nature, like in parks or somewhere in a bit of woods, forest.
Okay, and could you tell me how running changed your life?
I'm 30 now, and it changed a lot in me, especially when I realized this year I'm getting a bit old, I don't know. But I can feel changes in my body also. If I don't run, I get very slow and not too excited to live. I don't know, maybe because of the hormones. So when I go running every morning before I go to work. So around just 15 minutes. But during that moment, I realized it's the best thing to do to start your day by running, because it's like lighten up everything, and your brains like start working during that time, and it influenced me a lot while I'm working, because I realized if that day I miss running in the morning, I will get very lazy, and it's not just I can't really think clearly. I don't know.
Could you tell me if it's hard for you, the women, to be in a running competition?
I think there's a lot of women in marathon running competition, like the normal marathon. I can find in my country there's a lot of women, and actually the veteran, 35 above, they are better actually compared to the younger one. I don't know, maybe because of their experience. I realized that during the trail run, there's not much competition, not many women involved in trail run, I think. Maybe because it's still new here in Malaysia. But most of the runners are 35 years and above, and they run fast, they have faster timing than the younger one.
And compared to the men?
Oh, compared to the men is... I think they are everywhere, and they are more experienced maybe, because they travel a lot to go to international running competition compared to women.
Okay. And could you tell me if you have children?
I'm not married yet.
Do you want to have children?
Yeah, of course.
And when you are going to be a mom, would you stop running?
No, I will bring my children to run with me and get them involved in running since they are still young. It's a good thing to do. It's not just sports, it's like a lifestyle.
Do you think it will be hard for you to combine to being a mom, work maybe, and to be a runner?
I don't think it's a problem, because right now, even though I'm just working, not much commitment of family commitment, but I think if I have a family and become a mom, we can still do like outdoors during weekends, free time, running or joining competition. I think it won't be a problem. It's like, and running also gets you to go traveling, right? Because of course you get interested to go to other places to run, because they have different environment, and I'm going to bring my whole family. If I have children, all of them is going to go with me, so they get exposed from still young age.
And could you tell me if it's hard for you to run with your head covered?
Oh, okay, that is one thing actually. It depends on the type of head cover you use. For running, I will use something more light, and it's really simple and can just tuck in, and it won't be a burden, affecting my speed. It's just like covering my head and I can still run. Yeah, maybe protect me from any hazardous dust or anything to get into my ears.
Yeah, because for me, as I told your mom, it will be very hard for me to run with a cover head.
Oh, okay, yeah, maybe. It depends on the person also.
Could you tell me something about running, about women, that you want to share with other Malaysian women in the world?
That I want to share about running? If they are involved in the running, they are runners also, I think they also can feel that running is something very beautiful to do, because it's not just a sport. Unless it is making you stress, running is not just for competition. It's more than that. For me, it is something that I won't stop doing while I can still run, because it's like moving your whole body instead of just doing a simple workout. It's just a whole workout for the whole body, and yeah, can keep healthy, fit and happy. I think that's all.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is it for now. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I was really impressed with all the determination of Lina to practice her sports and to set up a standard for Malaysian female runners. If you like this episode, send me some comments and some stars, and let's give more visibility to women who run around the world. See you on my next episode. Bye!